Okay, so like I said, we've got to get our transduced signal from where it was transduced in the hair cells of the cochlea, carried via the sensory neuron axons. So that's what these are here. These sensory neurons, the axons, form the vestibulocochlear nerve, the cranial nerve, along with vestibular information from the vestibular apparatus related to balance. What is this? This is a ganglion. It's actually a cochlear nerve ganglion on the way in sensory information coming in. So this is still considered the axons here, still the cranial nerve, vestibular cochlear nerve that carries the information to the medulla. So this sensory information is coming in to the brainstem, right, instead of the spinal cord, like the rest of our body below our brain. It's going to synapse in the cochlear nucleus, which is a specific nucleus in the midbrain. So that's this right here. The information then goes across. This is another nucleus. This is the superior olive. It's another nucleus, olivary nucleus or olive nucleus. This is right at the pons and medulla junction. So it actually is a little bit more superior than the cochlear nucleus. So it's a second synapse. Actually, it's a third because you got ganglion one, two, three. The information is going to travel ascending through the midbrain. That's what this structure is here, towards the cerebrum. There's going to be a synapse in the inferior colliculus. You know about your colliculi, baby butt on a toilet seat. So this is the toilet seat you saw in the sheep brain. Toilet seat is what that says. So synapse there in the midbrain, and then a synapse in, where do you think this is? You know this one. This is the thalamus. And it's actually, remember the lateral geniculate nucleus is where, well, actually you saw it in lab. You'll see it in vision. This is the medial geniculate nucleus, MGN, of the thalamus. From there goes to the cortex, where specifically the primary auditory cortex. This is where it would be perceived. Your thalamus is a sensory, a relay station. It could decide to not send the information to your primary cortex. Like if you're sleeping, you might not be consciously aware of sounds, even though you're sensing them. All right, so these are the synapses. You've got the ganglia, cochlear nucleus, one, two, olivary nucleus, colliculus, thalamus, and then finally traveling to the cortex for perception. One more thing here, since we're showing this, you can see the information goes from the cochlear nucleus. There's actually one on each side, and actually crosses. This is the first place, the superior olive, where inputs from both ears come together. So eventually you can actually converge information from both ears. We're not going to go into more on this, but it's actually how you are able to detect localized sounds based on the difference of loudness between the two ears, which is, it has to come together then in your brain, has to be able to compare the sounds coming from both ears. That first happens actually in the brainstem, where we can compare both ears.